Hello students, now we are going to discuss some important topics in fourth lesson, electromagnetic induction and alternating current. First one is about AC circuit containing only an inductor. Look at the picture. An inductor L is taken and it is connected across an alternating voltage source capital B. The instantaneous value of the alternating voltage is written as V is equal to Vm sin omega t. This is equation number 1. Let small I be the alternating current flowing in the circuit due to this voltage, which induces a self-induced EMF, which is called back EMF across the inductor L. And it can be written as epsilon is equal to minus L into di by dt. Epsilon is equal to minus L into di by dt. This is equation number 2. We have studied about Kirchhoff's loop rule in second lesson. From that rule, we can write V is minus of minus epsilon is equal to 0, where V is equal to minus epsilon. From equation 1 and 2, this equation can be written as Vm sin omega t is equal to minus of minus L into di by dt, where Vm sin omega t is equal to L into di by dt. Hence, di becomes Vm by L into sin omega t into dt. By integrating on both sides, we can get I is equal to Vm by capital L integral sin omega t into dt. When we integrate sin omega t, we will get minus cos omega t by omega. So we can write the equation as I is equal to Vm by L into minus cos omega t by omega, which is equal to Vm by L omega into minus sin of pi by 2 minus omega t. Here cos omega t is replaced as sin of pi by 2 minus omega t, where I is equal to Vm by omega L into sin omega t minus pi by 2. Hence I is equal to Im sin of omega t minus pi by 2. Here Vm by L omega is replaced by capital Im, which represents the peak value of alternating current AC. From equation 1 and equation 3, it is clear that the current lags behind the applied voltage by the angle pi by 2, which is nothing but 90 degree. This is indicated in the phasor and the wave diagram. Next one is the definition for inductive reactance XL. In pure inductive circuit, L omega is the resistance offered by the inductor to the current flow, and it is called the inductive reactance XL. The unit for inductive reactance is ohm, where XL is equal to what? L omega, which can be written as 2 pi f into L. Here omega represents angular frequency, which is equal to 2 pi f. What is XL? XL is equal to L omega, which is equal to 2 pi f L. Next one is about an inductor blocks AC but it allows DC. Why and how? The DC current flows through an inductor produces uniform magnetic field, and the magnetic flux linked with the circuit remains constant. Hence, there is no self-induction and self-induced EMF, which is nothing but opposing EMF. So, DC current flows through an inductor. Once again, I repeat, the DC current flows through an inductor produces uniform magnetic field, and the magnetic flux linked with the circuit remains constant. Hence, there is no self-induction and self-induced EMF. So, DC current flows through an inductor. But AC flows through an inductor produces time-varying magnetic field, which in turn induces self-induced EMF. And this opposes any change in the current. Since AC varies both in magnitude and direction, it flows in opposite direction by producing the back EMF. Hence, the inductor blocks AC. Once again, I repeat, but AC flows through the inductor produces time-varying magnetic field, which in turn induces self-induced EMF. And this opposes any change in the current. Since AC varies both in magnitude and direction, it flows in an opposite direction by producing back EMF, so that the inductor blocks AC. Next one is about AC circuit containing only a capacitor. Look at the picture. A capacitor is taken and it is connected with the alternating voltage source. Let us consider a pure capacitor of capacitance capital C is connected across an alternating voltage source V. The instantaneous value of alternating voltage is given by V is equal to Vm sin omega t. This is equation number 1. Let us imagine Q be the instantaneous charge on the capacitor. The EMF across the capacitor at that instant can be written as epsilon is equal to Q by C. This is equation number 2. From Kirchhoff's loop rule, we can write V minus epsilon is equal to 0, where V is equal to epsilon. From equation 1 and 2, we can write this equation as Vm sin omega t is equal to Q by C, where Q is equal to C into Vm into sin omega t. By the definition of current, we can write I is equal to dq by dt. What is the definition for current? We know that rate of change of charge flowing through the conductor. So I can be written as dq by dt. Here Q is replaced by CVm sin omega t, which is given in the previous equation. So we can write CVm into d by dt of sin omega t. When we differentiate sin omega t, we will get cos omega t into omega. So that the equation becomes CVm into cos omega t into omega. Hence the equation becomes I is equal to omega CVm into sin pi by 2 plus omega t. Here cos omega t is replaced as what? Sin of pi by 2 plus omega t, which is equal to Vm by 1 by omega c. This omega CVm can also be written as Vm by 1 by omega c into sin of pi by 2 plus omega t, which is equal to small I is equal to capital Im into sin of omega t plus pi by 2. Here Vm by 1 by omega c is equal to Im, which represents the peak value of the current AC. From equation 1 and 3, it is clear that the current leads the applied voltage by the angle pi by 2, which is nothing but 90 degree. This is indicated in the phasor and the wave diagram. Next one is the definition for capacitive reactance XC. In pure capacitive circuit, 1 by omega C is the resistance offered by the capacitor and it is called capacitive reactance XC. The unit of capacitive reactance XC is ohm. The expression for the capacitive reactance can be written as XC is equal to 1 by omega C, which is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Here, omega denotes angular frequency. It is replaced by 2 pi F. Once again, I repeat the definition for capacitive reactance XC. In pure capacitive circuit, 1 by omega C is the resistance offered by the capacitor and it is called the capacitive reactance XC. The unit of capacitive reactance is ohm. Next one is about AC circuit containing an inductor and a capacitor in series or series or LC circuit. Look at the picture. Here the resistor R, the inductor L and the capacitor C are connected in series with the alternating voltage source. The applied alternating voltage is given by the equation V is equal to Vm sin omega t. This is equation number 1. Let small I represents the current flowing in the circuit at that instant. Hence the voltage developed across the resistor R, the inductor L and the capacitor C is given by Vr is equal to I into R. Here Vr is in phase with the current. Next, VL is equal to I into XL. Here, VL leads the current I by the angle pi by 2, such that 90 degree. Then, VC is equal to I into XC. Here, VC lags the current I by the angle pi by 2, such that the 90 degree. The phasor diagram is drawn by representing the current along OI vector and VR along OA vector, VL along OB vector and VC along OC vector. Look at that. From the picture, it is understood that VL is greater than VC. If VL is greater than VC, then the net voltage drop across LC combination is VL minus VC, which is represented by AD vector. By parallelogram law, the diagonal OE vector gives the resultant voltage V, which can be written as V is equal to root of VR squared plus VL minus VC the whole squared, which is equal to root of I squared R squared plus I into XL minus I into XE the whole squared. Inside the bracket, I squared is common. When you take root for I squared, you will get becomes V is equal to root of R squared plus XL minus XE the whole squared. Hence, I is equal to V by root of R squared plus XL minus XE the whole squared. This is equation number 4. This represents the current flowing through the circuit. In this equation, the term in the denominator root of R squared plus XL minus XE the whole squared is replaced by the term Z, which represents the impedance of the circuit. Impedance is nothing but a kind of resistance offered by the components in the circuit to the flow of current through the circuit. From the phasor diagram, the phase angle between the voltage V and the current I is found out by tan phi is equal to VL minus VC by VR, which is equal to XL minus XE by R. This is equation number 6. Next, we are going to discuss about some special cases. First special case, when XL is greater than XE, the phase angle phi is positive. It means that the voltage V leads the current I by the angle phi, such that V is equal to Vm sin omega t and I is equal to Im sin omega t minus phi. This circuit is said to be inductive. Next special case, when XL is less than XC, the phase angle phi is said to be negative. It means that the voltage lags behind the current by the angle phi, such that V is equal to Vm sin omega t and I is equal to Im sin omega t plus phi. This circuit is said to be capacitive. And next special case, when XL is equal to XE, the phase angle phi is 0. It means that the voltage V is in phase with the current I, such that V is equal to Vm sin omega t and I is equal to Im sin omega t. This circuit is said to be resistive. Next one is the definition for resonance in series RLC circuit. When the frequency of the applied source is equal to the natural frequency of the RLC circuit, the current in the circuit reaches its maximum value. Then the circuit is said to be in electrical resonance. The frequency at which resonance takes place is called resonant frequency. Hence, the condition for resonance can be written as XL is equal to XC. Once again I repeat the definition for resonance. When the frequency of the applied source is equal to the natural frequency of RLC circuit, then the current in the circuit reaches its maximum value. Then the circuit is said to be in electrical frequency at which resonance takes place is called resonant frequency. Hence the condition for the resonance can be written as XL is equal to XC. Next, let us discuss about some important questions. What are the applications of series RLC resonant circuit? RLC circuit have many applications like filter circuit, oscillators, voltage multipliers, etc. An important use of series RLC resonant circuit is in the tuning circuits of radio and TV systems. To receive the signal of a particular station among various broadcasting stations at different frequencies, tuning is done. Next question, resonance will occur only in LC circuits. Why? When the circuit contains both L and C, then the voltage across the inductor L and the capacitor C cancel one another when VL and VC are 180 degree out of phase. and the circuit becomes purely resistive. This implies that resonance will not occur in RL and RC circuits. Next one is about resonance in series RLC circuit. When the frequency of the applied alternating source is increased, the inductive reactance XL increases, whereas the capacitive reactance XC decreases. At particular frequency omega R, XL becomes equal to XC. At this stage, the frequency of the applied source omega R is equal to the natural frequency of the RLC circuit. The current in the circuit reaches its maximum value. Then the circuit is said to be in electrical resonance. The frequency at which the resonance takes place is called resonant frequency. Thus, at resonance, we can write XL is equal to XC, where XL is replaced as omega R into L, which is equal to XC is replaced as 1 by omega R into C. Hence, omega R squared will become 1 by LC. Hence, the resonant angular frequency will become omega R is equal to 1 by root LC. Here, omega R is replaced by 2 pi FR. Hence, the equation becomes 2 pi FR is equal to 1 by root of LC. From this equation, we can get the resonant frequency equation as FR is equal to 1 by 2 pi into root of LC. Next one is about effects of series resonance. When series resonance occurs, the impedance of the circuit is minimum. Impedance is nothing but a kind of resistance offered by the circuit and is equal to the resistance of the circuit, so that the current in the circuit becomes maximum, such that at resonance, impedance Z is equal to resistance R and Im is equal to Vm by R. The maximum current at resonance depends upon the value of the resistance capital R. For smaller resistance, larger the current with a sharper curve is obtained. But for the larger resistance, smaller the current with a flat curve is obtained, which is shown in figure. Thank you, students. Write your doubts in the comment box.